Before we go on, however, I have a couple of caveats here that I want to mention. So when we talked about system calls, there is actually a system call instruction in Y86 as well. So that IO trap instruction that's not covered in your textbook, but is in our version of Y86, that's a system call. It performs IO operations on characters, integers, and strings. So it supports input in the form of a single character or a decimal integer, and it takes one parameter which is passed in RDI, which is the address of where the data should be read in. I should mention that the IO trap instruction includes an identifier as part of the encoding, and the identifier is what tells you what kind of operation you're doing. So these are the six trap IDs or system call IDs here. So for input, there is character in, which is 1, and decimal in, which is 3. There are also three forms of output. You can output a single character, a single decimal integer, or an entire string. And again, this is controlled using a memory address that is passed using a register. And for output, the source memory address is RSI. So the three output trap IDs are char out, decimal out, and string out. And then there's also a flush, so this output is buffered until you call IO trap with the trap ID 5, in which case it is flushed to the standard out. And in P4, you'll simulate these system calls using standard C functions like printf and scanf. But if this was a real operating system, this would be implemented using much lower level mechanisms. So it turns out that some of the functions we've been using in C are actually just wrappers for a system call or for multiple system calls. So for example, fopen, fread, and malloc, these are all just wrappers for underlying system calls. So there's a system call called open, that's what fopen does. There's one called read, which is what fread is doing, and then mmap, which is what malloc is doing. So these system call interfaces are defined by standards. The two big ones are System5 and POSIX. We're using the POSIX ones this semester. And so in general, these system call wrappers are called system level functions. So these are functions, but they're sort of just wrapping kernel code. And it's important to check for errors after calling these functions. And we've done this to a certain extent in the projects in this course. The textbook uses wrapper functions for these. So for instance, it will define an uppercase O open function that is itself a wrapper for the open system call and checks the return value and everything. So, you know, this is quite important. So the textbook provides these wrappers. This is good practice, but we will be omitting the error handling in some of the examples that we show you just to simplify them so that there's not a ton of extra code that you have to look at in order to understand what's going on. But of course, if you're using these functions in a real program, you should always be checking the return values and all of the error conditions to make sure that your code is robust in the case or in the presence of failures. I also want to mention one thing about how your textbook talks about the environment parameters to main, which is that the ENV parameter to main, that's not actually standard. And so if you want to be POSIX compliant and adhere to the standard, the get ENV function is really the only environmental mechanism that is defined by the POSIX C99 standard, which is what we're using in this course. So those are just a couple of caveats before we move on.